Imagine climbing this high, or scaling these heights. Or how about taking a crack at this? Looks pretty tough, right? Well, Warren McDonald has done it all without legs.
Now, I had doctors years ago tell me I'd never be able to walk again, and it was like, okay, I'll prove you wrong on that first, but it's, you know, and then take it a step further. I never said I wouldn't be able to climb.
Born in Melbourne, Australia, Warren started out like a lot of people, not sure what he wanted to do with his life, so he ended up taking an office job. But you know that feeling when you're like, this sucks, I'd like a little more adventure. That's what he did. Warren started traveling the world. Eventually, he landed in Tasmania, where his love for the outdoors flourished. He campaigned to save forests and decided to be a hiking guide. But 1997, on a trip to an Australian island, Warren's life took a tragic turn. He was hiking up a mountain when a slab of rock came crashing down on him. The rock weighed a ton, literally. That rock crushed his legs and trapped Warren for 2 days before help arrived. His legs were severely damaged. Doctors had to amputate both. But Warren bounced back in a big way. In 2003, this guy became the first double above-knee amputee to climb Mount Kilimanjaro, Africa's tallest peak. It didn't stop there. He followed it up with El Capitan in Yosemite and Alberta's Weeping Wall, which is a virtual vertical skating rink.
That was a piece of cake. I'm glad I don't have to do the approach again, huh?
Warren now lives in Vancouver, and he's told his story in a book called A Test of Will. Perhaps you've seen him share it with the world as a motivational speaker. That's an incredible story, and here he is, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome Mr. Warren McDonald.
How are you? Good to see you. I suspect, you know,
I mean, the book is a test of will, one man's extraordinary story of survival. It certainly is that. If people are, I mean, they just saw the video of you there, that what you went through. Yep. I mean, tell us, what happened? How did this accident happen?
What happened? Wrong place, wrong time.
Which really sucks, man, because to be so random like that.
Yeah, well, life can be random. But literally, that's what it was. I was on the side of a mountain, climbing a peak with a guy I'd just met the day before. And literally, I was climbing out of a gully to take a leak, trying to do the right thing and get as far away as from our water supply as I could. A big piece of rock peels off, lands in my lap. You know, but good luck and bad luck sometimes come hand in hand, because you know, I was obviously pretty lucky that it didn't land up on my waist, and
yeah,
I wouldn't be sitting here today.
You'd be gone. I mean, yeah. When you say a big piece of rock fell, like
what's
how quick is that?
Like that.
Do you hear a noise? Do you wonder what it is?
And yeah, I heard a crack, and the next split second's totally gone. It's just absolutely gone from memory. Next thing I knew, I was just slammed into the creek bed with just this incredible weight grinding
the thing,
my legs.
If that isn't enough, I mean, the amount of time you spend pinned under this rock is incredible.
Yeah, the best part of 2 days.
So, 45 hours or so, you're pinned under this rock a lot, and you're in the wild. A lot can happen to you.
Yeah, a lot can happen. A hell of a lot can happen. I thought I was going to drown at first. I fell.
Was the water rising?
Yeah, exactly. Well, when I fell with my backside barely touching the water in the creek. It starts raining, and we're in the tropics. Mm-hmm. So when it rains, it really rains. And within an hour and a half, I've got a raging, flooding creek up around my waist, thinking, wow, this is grim. I don't know if I'm going to come out of this.
Now, I read this, and I have to you have to explain this to us, because the idea of a lobster is eating at your dying legs.
Yeah, not happy.
Okay, how does that? What does that? Tell me that.
Well, I'll tell you what I tried to do. When you're stuck under a rock like that, you want time. You want to will time
right
forward. You don't want to be there. So I tried to sleep as much as I could. And eventually, I was lapsing in and out of consciousness, I think. Mm-hmm. So they tell me. And at one point, I just looked up and I saw a pool of blood around my right foot and just thought, that's weird. That wasn't there before. It's a little late to start bleeding now.
Yeah.
And next thing, I see this nipper come up out of the water. It's like, I don't think so. I don't think so. And yeah, had got a stick and just started spearing at this guy and, you know, trying to take him out. Because I couldn't believe the cheek of this guy to come and start chewing on me like that when there's nothing I could do.
I wonder, when you look back now,
yep.
I mean, what do you think about that time?
What do I think about it? For a long time, well, let's put it this way, a good friend of mine lost a leg and used to say that it was the best thing that ever happened to him.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, I don't think so. Now, I'm a realist, I'll deal with what's happened to me. But in the last couple of years, I've come to the point where I've realised that if I could turn the clock back now, mm-hmm. I wouldn't.
Why not?
Because I've come too far and learnt too much. In a nutshell.
What was that moment like when you woke up and went, this is me, this is who I am now?
In a way, it was pretty liberating in a way to get to that point, you know, and it was an amazing process to go through because I got to the point where navigating life without legs isn't a big deal at all for me. You know, I sort of hesitate to say this, but in some ways it can be pretty easy. You know, anybody that's gone shopping with me in a supermarket will tell you that a wheelchair is pretty quick zipping around. You got a basket underneath, you're just grabbing stuff and throwing it under the chair. And so when you get your systems in place and you learn how to navigate life in a different way, that becomes the non-issue. And it's the things that you've learned about yourself and just life and the universe and everything else in general that I wouldn't change that now.